Here's problem 1424. A thin rectangular piece of wood floats in water. You slowly pour oil with a density equal to that of the wood on the surface of the water until the height of the oil above the water is twice the height of the piece of wood. Which statement is correct? All right, so we want to just know what's going to happen when we pour the oil on the piece of wood. Let's take a look at what's happening originally. We have this piece of wood, and we're looking at a cross-section of it as it's floating in water. Of course, the wood has weight, so there's a force of weight going down. But there's also a buoyant force equal to the weight of the water displaced going up. And that's the way we normally look at this floating problem. However, the air above the water is also a fluid. So there's a very tiny buoyant force due to the displaced air, and that is part of this equilibrium as well. So the weight of the block is equal to the two buoyant forces, the buoyant force of the water displaced and the buoyant force of the air displaced. Sounds good. That's the way it's working. All right, so let's take a look at this situation where this weight is going down. But now we're going to start to fill in the air with oil. So as we start to fill in the air with oil above the surface of the water, what's going to happen? Well, the immediate effect is, even though the water is still being displaced at this moment, the same amount, the buoyant force of the air is now being partially replaced by the buoyant force of the oil. And the buoyant force of the oil, being more dense than the air, is going to be a little bit greater than the buoyant force of the air. We still have a little bit, as we're in transition, we still have a little bit of a buoyant force of air here. In other words, we're going to have a net force that is actually going to start moving this thing in an upward direction. So this block will start to move upward with some speed as the buoyant force of the oil is slightly greater than the buoyant force of the air. And this will continue as we're displacing and adding more and more oil. So eventually, we get to the point where the block is in the oil above the water, and we have all this oil around it. And at this moment, the weight of the block is being perfectly balanced by the displaced weight of the oil, which is of the same density as the wood itself, the block itself. So the weight of the block is exactly being displaced by the oil. There's no extra impetus for it to continue to move upward. Hence, even though this oil is twice the height of the block itself, the block will rest on the surface of the water inside the oil. So be in the oil just above the surface of the water where it reaches another stable equilibrium.